So right now I'm heading out to Angleton, Texas. I'm gonna visit the Crocodile Encounter Park. And I happened to come across this on the Facebook events page last night when I was scrolling through. I was trying to find something that I wanted to put on this next episode of Journeys with John. The Crocodile Encounter Park claims to have the most crocodiles within a facility within the state of Texas. So I've been to some other zoos and parks where they've had crocodiles, but I can't really truly say that I've ever been within maybe 10 feet of one. So I'm hoping that that's what the Crocodile Encounter Park is going to be able to do for me. They also mentioned on Facebook that they do a live feeding, which I'm also excited about because I've never seen that in person. I've seen that in documentaries and seen that in online, but to actually see it in person is another thing. I brought my camera gear, obviously the camera I'm recording with right now. And basically I'm just gonna try to document the tour that I'm getting and the live feeding and anything else that's there. Hopefully I'll snatch an interview or two. And at the end of the video, I'll go ahead and post a review as to, you know, is it worth driving out 45 minutes from Houston to visit this park?
What kind of camera is that? Oh, it's filming right now. I'm sorry. The Lumix?
Yeah, GH5.
I should have had Nikon D7100. I haven't tried filming on it yet. I'm mainly photograph reptiles.
Come on, alligators. So when they hear that, they have great hearing. You have better hearing than most other reptiles. They hear that, they know it means food. Make a jump for this one. Here. Up, 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 up. Up. Gonna have to jump for it. Come on. Come on. There you go. Pretty good jump.
My name's Andrew Austin, and I'm a tour guide out here at Crocodile Encounter in Angleton, Texas. We are a zoological facility that specializes in keeping crocodiles. And my job here is to educate the public on these animals. They're keystone predators and ecosystems, so they're very, very important for the planet and very misunderstood animals. And our main goal is conservation and education. Now we keep crocodiles here that are critically endangered in the wild. So we keep and breed those. School groups come in almost every day during the week. We bring them around the park. We do really fun, you know, very interactive tours for the kids. Generally, people leave with a smile on their face and hopefully knowing a lot more about these animals.
And that's not just alligators and crocodiles out here. We do keep snakes, we keep lizards. And we also have a large tortoise herd, so you can come down and feed the tortoises, you know, get down there and, you know, feed them by hand, pet them on the shell. We also keep mammals here, and it's not just reptiles. We keep two species of antelope. We keep one species of primate, we keep goats, we have kangaroos and possums, and so a lot of animals out here. We are a full functioning zoo. It's not just an alligator park or a crocodile park. We do have over 100 animals here. You know, we also do a lot of traveling shows around Texas. So we go to schools and we do assembly programs. We can go to your house for a birthday party. You can also do your birthday party here. So we do all kinds of stuff. It's not just tours. A big part of what we do, but we also go out and we travel with our animals, bring smaller reptiles on the road, and bring them to schools and festivals to educate people and give people a very, you know, very fun, very hands-on experience.
So I just got back from the Crocodile Encounter Park, and I've got to say that I was completely blown away by the whole experience. Just the fact that not only was their park way bigger than I thought it was going to be, and so many more animals that I wasn't expecting, but the fact that the employees there were so hospitable. I got the interview, as you just saw, and they were just very happy to help me out in general. They catered to anything I needed. I even got a behind the scenes look at some other animals they had in the back, and I didn't film any of it, unfortunately, because I literally ran out of memory card right after my interview, which I'm super, super sad about. I'm gonna go back as soon as my semester's over and I graduate, and as soon as the rockets win the NBA finals, hopefully. I'm gonna just say they win it instead of saying they get eliminated. It was an amazing experience. The fact that I was probably within Yao Ming distance of some of the animals that were really dangerous or that I just couldn't touch was pretty awesome. I even got to touch some of the animals, like the turtles they had, and I even got to touch a snake and a baby alligator, which was so awesome. It was literally about this big, as a little tiny baby. And it actually almost peed on me too, by the way. I don't have that on footage, but I managed to swing it and it peed on the ground. So I was happy about that. Overall, it was so amazing. I highly recommend it to anyone who just likes animals or just wants to check out crocodiles or these other awesome animals that they have, like kangaroos, lemurs, snakes, other reptiles, miscellaneous reptiles. I couldn't speak more highly of this place if I wanted to. So check it out, Crocodile Encounter Park at Angleton, Texas. It is totally worth the 45-minute drive from Houston down there. I will say that. And thanks for tuning in.